today is Friday, and you know what that means for all of us gamers out there. The PlayStation Move came out today, and mine just came in the mail. Now, you all know my history of unboxing videos. You know that I get a little crazy because I'm so excited. Well, I am. Text message. Now, what was I saying? Oh, yeah. So I'm excited for the PlayStation Move, okay? And mine came in the mail, which my UPS guy is very sneaky, okay? I was up all day trying to stay awake and wait for him to come and give it to me. And all I know, I fall asleep, which I don't remember doing that. I fell asleep, and he sneaks it to my house at my door. So I was trying to listen for him. He's very quick. He'll come in, drop it off, and leave out. And his truck is making all kinds of noise. And you would think I would hear it because he's right there at my window. But I didn't hear it. But he dropped it off, and I have the PlayStation Move and the navigation controller right here, ready to open. And we're going to get started with that in just a minute. But I wanted to tell you really quick, I was planning to do the unboxing video, but I was also going to plan, I was also planning to do the first gameplay of the game, iPet, which is for the PlayStation Move, which you all heard me speak of it before. I am so excited for this particular game because I just love cute stuff anyway, cute animals. And I've been wanting iPads since the first time I fell in love with it back here in March, okay? So, I cannot wait to go and get it. Now, I was hoping I could get it at Walmart today, but I could not because I have a brand new niece that's being born today as we speak. As you're watching this video, she's on her way here being brought to the world by God Express. And I'm excited for that. So I had a lot of good things going on today. I'm having my first niece being born. I got the PlayStation Move that just came in the mail. And I'm going to Walmart to get iPad. So I was going to do the first few minutes of iPad, the gameplay. But that's not going to happen. Which is okay. That's fine. I'll just do a video one day of just, you know, afterwards. I guess this weekend. Just introducing you to iPad and my little pet. Okay? Now, why don't we go ahead and get started on this unboxing? You know how that's gonna go. Wasn't funny. Try this in. trade-in system, and I highly, highly, highly recommend it. In fact, I will tell you right now, don't ever go to GameStop ever again and trade your games. Through Amazon, the games go for a much higher value depending on what year they came out, how long they've been out, and what system they're for. I was able to trade in some games that, number one, I didn't like anymore. Number two, I knew I wasn't going to play again. And number three, I spent 95% of the time frustrated with the game than actually enjoying it. So I was able to trade in 8 games that I've accumulated that I didn't particularly care for and didn't mind giving up to Amazon. And it was Mod Nation Racers that really helped me get over the top of what I actually needed, more than enough than what I needed. And I traded in a couple of DS games, which I've noticed that traded in for $10, actually. Most of them trade for $10. So, depending on, like I said, what system you got the game for, depends on the value of the price. Like I said, you will not be ripped off. I mean, these are reasonable prices, okay? So, I traded the game and actually accumulated more than what I needed. The navigational controller goes for about $29, I think, or $39. The PlayStation Move goes for about $49, or $59, or I think it's $49. Together, they went about $78. I was like, oh my god, I got more than enough just off these game trade-ins alone to pay for that. Then, I forgot all about that I was awarded $10 for pre-ordering Toy Story 3, the game, for the PlayStation. I was awarded $10. So, that's why I say trade through Amazon, because they award you for this kind of stuff. Depending on the game that you're getting, if it's a well-known game, you're going to get something back for pre-ordering it, okay? So, I got that, and I was able to pay for both controllers without paying nothing out of my pocket. Now, this trade-in system is just awesome. You look for the games that you want to trade in for the system that you have them for, and you keep hitting, you trade them all up and accumulate this list. Then you confirm the list of games that you search for and that you're going to trade in. They give you two things to print out. One is a note that goes in the box to the merchant, and then one is the actual address that goes to where you need to send the games to the merchant, okay? So you send it in the mail, he gets the games, and about a week later, during this whole process, it takes about a week for the games, to get to them, however fast you try to get it to them. The faster you get it to them, the quicker the response. I trade my stuff in super fast. And I send it in the mail to him, and he gets it. And in about the week that he gets it, however the process they goes, they'll check the games to make sure they're not, defective, that they're not glitchy, and that the cases are fine, no cracks, whatever the case may be, no scratches on the game, whatever the case may be. They check it, and then in the email, they'll give you a gift card on Amazon, because you have to have an account on Amazon for this to work. They'll give you a gift card on Amazon with the amount that you accumulated, the value of all the games all together that you accumulated from your trade-ins, and it goes onto the gift card for you to use towards any game or any accessory for your system or games. So that's what happened. I had $90, okay? Eight games gave me $90, all right? Plus the $10 that I needed, that I got for pre-ordering Toy Story 3 for the PlayStation. So that was what I needed. So all of that paid for both controllers and the shipping. So, I didn't have to pay for nothing out of pocket, which technically means I kind of got it for free, pretty much. And I'm so happy about that. And that's why I'm telling you, I highly recommend going to GameStop. Not GameStop. Don't go to GameStop ever again to trade in your games, because they rip people off. From my experience, they ripped me off, alright? So, go to Amazon. Use Amazon. You'll get more for your value of the games that you have. Trust me on this. Just go through Amazon, okay? And that's about it. Now, like I said, I wanted to do an iPad gameplay video, but I won't get a chance to do that. But that's okay. I'm going to go and enjoy these now, okay? I think in about an hour, I will have that chance to finally get to Walmart and get the game, and then give more information about my little niece that is being born today. Very excited about that. Today is just an all-around great day. I have a lot of stuff going on, and I'm just excited about it. So, I'm going to be an aunt. I'm just excited. So, I will go and enjoy these and let you guys know what I think about it. I may do a review on the PlayStation Move. Who knows? I'm sure I'm going to be in amongst a lot of people that's going to be doing reviews on this thing. And some may like it, some may not. But who cares? I know I'm going to like it because I spent a lot of money. money on it, okay? But anyway, I will see you guys later. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Enjoy your Friday. For those who have the PlayStation Move, enjoy it. Enjoy it. Enjoy it. Maybe I'll see you online. I think you can go online with iPad. If you're getting iPad, let me know. I have linked down there to the group, to the iPad group that I made, to a website which is like a MySpace for gamers called playfire.com. Go there. Check it out. I got an iPad group right there for any of you who want to upload pictures or videos, whatever the case may be, of you and your iPad. Okay? So I will see you guys.